Welcome to the Forbes Georgia studio. Today with our guests, we'll be speaking about SMEs and the support that USAID is providing to Georgian SMEs during pandemic and post-pandemic period. Thank you for watching us, and thank you for being with us and taking our questions. It turned out that SMEs is like the joint effort of all IFIs, of all development agencies. It's kind of like the main focus of the post-pandemic agenda. Why?
Small and medium-sized enterprises are really play major role in development of economies around the world, and Georgia is not an exception. They represent majority of Georgian private sector, and they account for 65% of total employment. So they are important. They are important for Georgia's inclusive and sustainable development, and that's why we, as an international donor agency, we are focusing our efforts on SME support.
And probably they are the hardest hit also during this pandemic, right?
Definitely, definitely.
Yes. So let's start with the specific projects that are targeting SMEs from different points of view, so to say, and answering like different needs and different tackling different challenges that this sector in Georgia says. For example, to take one program, 400 new full-time jobs and over 15 million. USD leverage in private equity capital, quite ambitious goals of the new three-year program that also focuses mainly on SMEs. What are some of the tools and mechanisms through which you intend to reach these quite ambitious goals?
Our partner is Gazelle Finance, and you probably have heard of them. They are managing a 31 million investment fund for in Georgia, providing equity and debt financing for SMEs in various fields. With our support, our financial assistance to Gazelle Finance, they can really provide high quality technical assistance to their existing and potential portfolio companies, so that they the companies can really improve their management systems, become more productive, and access new domestic and international market.
If I'm not mistaken, this is missions like first time to work in such close cooperation with the fund.
Exactly. So while we have relatively well developed banking sector, alternative forms of finance providers such as equity funds, venture capital industries that are typically a key source of finance for high risk, high growth enterprises in more advanced markets, they are still very underdeveloped in Georgia. And one key barrier there is that really the level of sophistication of SMEs is quite low still in Georgia, and that creates kind of a transaction cost between enterprises and private investors. So working with Gazelle Finance, we are able to really provide a blended instrument, which is a combination of technical assistance, know-how, and investment facility, investment capital that is provided by Gazelle Finance.
And then let me turn to Marina now, because that's where the skills part will be added, right? Your program, Marina, aims to train roughly 5,000 individuals, incentivize 30 businesses to develop long-term partnerships with training providers, and mobilize $7 million USD in cost share from the private sector.
Every survey that was conducted in Georgia shows that there is the mismatch in the skills that the skills providers and graduates have, and the needs that the private sector have for expansion. So this program is specifically aimed to resolve this problem. But this problem can only be resolved if the lasting and sustainable relationships is established between the employers and the skill providers. Right now, the problem that we have that these two entities practically do not speak with each other. The surveys also show that, tell us that only 1 or 2% of the employers have any relationships with the skill providers. So obviously skill providers cannot provide the skills that they need if there is no communication. And the biggest ambition of this program is to change this relationship and to change it sustainably. So we have the implementing entity, American organization that will be implementing this program. And this organization will help private sector and skill providers to develop the models of this engagement. This already exists outside, and we will try to bring those best practices and to adjust them to the Georgian reality. Probably this is biggest grant investment in skills in Georgia that is made by one program.
Mm-hmm. This to me seems like a very good and sustainable step towards inclusive growth that we are speaking. Absolutely. I have some other numbers as well, because yeah. This program should ensure that at least 35% of trainees come from rural areas and or ethnic minority communities, and at least 45% are women. Does pandemic also play a role here? Because we see that especially these groups that are identified are also hardest hit.
Absolutely, I agree. And those numbers, I think, even are more ambitious than the total number, because what is happening in Georgia is that access to the skills in general is to the skills training programs in general is scarce, but in the rural areas, it practically does not exist. Most of our skill providers are concentrated either in Tbilisi, Batumi, or maybe in Kutaisi. And the rest of Georgia, there is nothing, which creates another constraint to the rural economic development and inclusive growth, which is a priority for USAID and also for the government. So you know, we will specifically focus on developing the high quality skills programs in the rural areas that responds to the economic requirements of those regions. And especially focus will be on the ethnic minorities and the people with the special needs. And you mentioned the women participation. You know that in Georgia, we have pretty good numbers in women participation in education. Actually, in tertiary education, I think women participation is even higher than the men. But what we see...
Probably the journalism is also that sphere.
Yes. But what we see afterwards is that the salaries that women receive, first of all, women participation in the workforce is lower than the men. And the salary of women, average salary, is much lower than the men. The reason is that for social norms or the cultural norms or for different reasons, women are mostly choosing the professions that are less paid than the men's. This is one reason, and then another reason are that the men are more on the managerial positions. A share of the men on the managerial positions are higher than the women. So we want to increase specifically women's participation on the programs where we have the highly paid jobs.
Let me now turn to the private sector engagement, and emphasis on rural Georgia is in this program as well.
Thank you, Elena, for this opportunity to speak to USAID's new priorities for private sector engagement. It's something that we are taking very seriously and ambitiously in the rollout and the implementation of our country strategy. As Sovico and Marina both spoke to, we have two new programs that are supporting SMEs and upgrading skills, and they'll both benefit the rural areas and SMEs in different ways. But this is part of a larger strategy we have for working hand in hand with the private sector to co-create solutions that really will yield results long after USAID's assistance has ended. For example, we have already worked with the Georgian Farmers Association to address constraints that the Ajar group was having to source their produce locally. And we worked with them in a way in which they developed a mobile matchmaking solution in which farmers were linked with buyers. Mm-hmm. That platform went on to increase sales by 4 million for farmers and has been taken up by other buyers in the industry, including hotels and restaurants.
And your focus in rural Georgia is on startups and innovative solutions, innovations.
Exactly. Exactly. Because in those areas, that's what's needed. And the private sector is the best investor in terms of bringing about those innovations. We are placing this emphasis on the private sector as they are the engines of growth. And in the rural areas, that's really needed right now. And post-pandemic, that's critical. The lack of tourism, the lack of access to e-commerce platforms, the low business activity that's been impacting rural areas over the past year has really created a very difficult challenge for rural areas and rural businesses. So through all these programs and this special emphasis on working with the private sector to stimulate activity, we're hoping to sort of shore up and bridge that gap. Another example we have of this approach is we've worked with McDonald's in the past year where we're certifying suppliers so that they can source locally their lettuce, for example, for their restaurants, which they're importing right now, but that can be a valuable income stream to farmers and local suppliers. So in this way, we're trying to bring about the market actors to support investment and really generate business activity in the regions.
Yes.
And create jobs.
Yes, this focus on co-creating win-win supply chain solutions, this seems to be a very important skill, so to say, that SME sector could have, because we hear that a lot might change on the supply chains after the pandemic. The European Union, for example, also thinking of bringing closer the supply chains, and because of the CFTA, Georgia might be well positioned to use that. So what is exactly this win-win supply chain solutions, and how USAID is helping SMEs and broadly business in Georgia in that direction?
Thank you for that question. The win-win solution is really about working with the private sector as a source of ideas, innovation, investment, shared advocacy, and resources, not just resources alone. It's working with them across the board for solutions that advance their core business interests, but also deliver on addressing the development challenges. And we find that by working in this way, we can support the larger business actors in meeting their needs, come up with a very strong, sustainable impact that addresses the development issues at hand. The AgroNofti mobile matchmaking platform is a perfect example because that's a win-win for those buyers in the hotel and restaurants that are trying to source locally, but at the same time, allowing farmers to connect to a platform in which they meet that demand. And we support them to meet that standard in quality and quantity. So this is the type of solutions that we're looking for, and where Georgia's at right now, this is an area where we have an emerging network of private sector partners to work with in this way. What Sofiko was mentioning about the Gazelle finance program, this is an excellent way of supporting those emerging actors in the economy and businesses that can then become that partner to co-invest in smaller SMEs. And this will pay dividends across the board for Georgia and especially in rural areas.
Yes, Sofiko mentioned that the number of SMEs is really big and they are the main employer in the country. But also, so if we look what share they have in overall GDP, we will see that this is quite low. What are some challenges there and how do these programs that we have talked about, how they are addressing this challenge? And this question goes to all three of you from your perspective, of course, but Sofa, let's
start.
Yeah,
so I actually already alluded to this challenge that we identify, which is access to diversified sources of investment funds and the technical assistance. Structural reforms that actually help to upgrade the sophistication level of SMEs and deepen financial markets beyond the traditional banking products is necessary to tackle that problem.
For the skills program, it is very rare that the donor has a program where the sectors are not identified, the approaches are not already identified in the design. This is not the case for our program. We are open, we are ready to listen to the private sector to understand their needs and co-create those grants and the grant facility to respond to their needs. We have not selected. We could have done the analysis
of the framework and then yeah. Choose from there.
Yes. But no, we are ready. We will just have the criteria to assess what will be the best value for our investments, and the best value, it will be the guarantee of employment and the need of those skills that and the programs that we will create in the labor market, the value that the graduates will create for their employers, and the possibility and the salaries that they will get in future.
That's so where we already see the share in GDP rising. Thank you.
I'd like to sort of highlight that the race to find a vaccine and roll it out worldwide underscores the critical need for private-public cooperation, and in particular the private sector's role to innovate and to bring those things to market. And I think that when you're speaking to the resiliency needed at this moment to recover from the pandemic, to get the economy going again, we need this cooperation more than ever. And so USAID is taking a concerted effort to build it into each one of our programs. And I love the industry-led skills development program because it is about being a partner to the major employers, to the major industries, in meeting the needs that they have for skilled labor and working with them to develop programs that answer to those needs. So it's market driven, but it will also deliver huge benefits for Georgians across the country who are going to have those skills and have that close ability to work in those industries and in those companies.
Yes, thank you so much for giving us very important insights into these programs. And just to sum up our conversation, what is your main message to SMEs today, to our viewers and followers of the Checkpoint?
We invite cooperation with SMEs, with the private sector, as a source of ideas, innovation, investment, shared advocacy, and we're ready to work with private sector partners in ways that we haven't in the past, not just in our programming, but actually in the design and co-creating these solutions to development challenges.
We are ready to help them to make really lasting changes, but we want the full participation from these stakeholders. We are ready to work with each of them separately and all of them together to reach those objectives that we have for this program. And I want to add one more thing about, we spoke about the international certification, and this is very important for the quality of the programs that we will create, But even more important, it is for the sustainability of those programs. Because in this era of innovation and the change, our programs will also become obsolete very soon. But that's why it's important that they build those international partnerships so that they will change mm-hmm. also as soon as the yes. world and the yes. West is
changing. They will have
changing.
The skill to adapt as
to
well.
Adapt, and yes, and they like will the have the partner that will stay with them after we are gone.
And we see small and medium enterprises as a critical to Georgia's economic development. This is... Again, a good invitation for private sector finance providers, private sector actors to co-create so we can come up with these development solutions.
Thank you so much, and I hope SME sector and all the stakeholders that you have mentioned will use this opportunity and this invitation. Thank you for being with us again.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.